Hello everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER, and in this video I would like to talk about how to use a BSP in AppWizard. Because the BSPs in AppWizard are the fastest way to get a GUI onto a target board. So when you do a new project in AppWizard, you have the choice to select a BSP right here. And these are the BSPs that are currently included in AppWizard. So you have an image of the board, you have the board name, the size of the display that's on the board, the color scheme, which MCU is on the board, and then which IDE the BSP will create the project for, and then the manufacturer. So this column is really important because essentially that is the IDE that you're going to build the project with that is going to get generated by AppWizard. So you can select the board that you have, and then you have an empty canvas and you can start building your GUI from the various elements that are available in AppWizard and emWin, the SEGGER graphics library that's underneath it. So you can try this with a GUI from scratch, or you can also use one of the examples that are included in AppWizard. So for example, for this ST evaluation board that I have on my desk right now, we have this climate control demo. So I'm going to open this. And since this particular example has user code in it, it is not going to work correctly with the AppWizard play mode, so I'm not going to do that, but we want to build it anyway and run it on our real target board down here. So I need to make sure I'm using the correct BSP for this, and I can do that in the project options. So here I'm going to select the BSP for our STM32L4R9i discovery board. And that tells AppWizard the display size, the color format, and all that. So now what I can do is do an export and save operation. And that generates all the code required to run the example on our board, including the project for our IDE, which in this case is SEGGER Embedded Studio, which is why I have this open over here. So I can show you over here what's happened on the file level. So AppWizard generated 4 separate folders, one for the resources, that's all the images and text and such, one for Visual Studio Simulation, which we'll cover in a different video. And then there's the source and target folders. The source folder contains all the required code for the project. And the target folder here contains the actual project for, in this case, the Embedded Studio IDE. So this is the project file. And I can double click this to open Embedded Studio. Now here are all the files that are part of the project. I can look at the application folder, and there's our resource and source folders that got created by AppWizard. So these hold our GUI. And this project is ready to be built. So I can just say, build this project. And it's going to start compiling. Just a quick word on Embedded Studio while this is building here. Embedded Studio is our all-in-one solution IDE. It includes 3 toolchains. It runs cross-platform, and it's free for non-commercial use. And after it's built, I can use the onboard debugger on this discovery board here to directly download the project into my board. So I can say debug go. And on this board, I have replaced the ST-Link with a SEGGER J-Link firmware that we have because it's much faster. So I'm downloading the project into the flash on this microcontroller board. And once it's done programming and verifying, I can just run the project. If you would like to learn more about the SEGGER J-Link and the underlying technology, I invite you to visit our website and check that out. So the code is downloaded and we're sitting at main, and I can simply say go, and we can see our project and our GUI on our eval board, and I can interact with it and make sure that it works as expected, which it does. So once you're at that stage, you can go back to AppWizard, make more modifications to your GUI. You can add more user code or modify the user code in your IDE, and then just do another export and save and rebuild it in your IDE, and that way you can steadily build your GUI. If you're working with a board for which there's currently no AppWizard BSP, or it's not generating the correct project for the correct IDE you're looking for, please contact us or also contact your microcontroller provider, and potentially such a BSP can be created for you. You can also create your own custom BSPs. So for example, here in the user guide for AppWizard, we have a whole section on BSPs. And one of them is how to create your own custom BSP. So you could create your own BSP for the board and for the IDE you're using by following this example here. Or if you got a custom BSP from your silicon vendor, you can follow this procedure to import the custom BSP into your AppWizard. So in a nutshell, this is what I wanted to tell you about the AppWizard BSPs and how they work, and how you can use BSPs to quickly get your project onto a target board. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out our other videos on AppWizard, and thanks for watching.